11 facts you need to know about the Kuiper Belt. The Kuiper Belt is one of the most distant objects in the solar system. But although our astronomical observation technologies have improved dramatically during the last decades, we're still not able to observe all the objects in this distant region of the solar system. It's for this reason why the Kuiper Belt is one of the most mysterious places. And in this video, we will show you 11 impressive things you should know about the Kuiper Belt. Ready? Let's get started. Number 11. Does not contain any asteroids. When talking about the Kuiper Belt, it is usually described as an asteroid belt similar to the one between Mars and Jupiter, but located beyond Neptune. Although this idea is very close, we must remember that asteroids are strictly those smaller rocky objects that orbit the Sun and are found in the asteroid belt between Mars and Jupiter. That is, any other similar object that is found outside this zone cannot be classified as an asteroid, even if it has the same physical characteristics. This means that although the Kuiper Belt has many objects, they are not classified as asteroids. So what are they called? The correct term for them is Kuiper Belt objects, which from now on will classify as KBOs, and cover all objects within the belt regardless of their size. They are also often called trans-Neptunian objects since they are located beyond the orbit of Neptune. Number 10. It is larger than the asteroid belt. Although our telescopes do not allow us to see all of the KBOs, thanks to data collected by the Minor Planet Center of the Smithsonian Astrophysical Observatory, we know that the number of KBOs can be up to 200 times more massive than the asteroid belt between Mars and Jupiter. This means that in the Kuiper Belt, it is equivalent to 200 asteroid belts. Can you imagine that? The total mass of the asteroid belt includes the mass of the dwarf planet Ceres and the mass of asteroids Vesta, Pallas, Juno, and Hygieia. These objects together represent more than 50% of the mass of the entire asteroid belt. But if the Kuiper Belt has 200 times more mass, does this mean there could be another 200 dwarf planets the size of Ceres in this region? Let us know your opinion in the comments. Number 9. The Kuiper Ice. As we said earlier, KBOs cannot be classified as asteroids since they are located outside the asteroid belt. Still, in addition to not being in the exact location, Kuiper Belt objects have another difference concerning asteroids. That difference is that while asteroids are mainly composed of rock and metal, KBOs are mainly comprised of frozen volatiles. These are chemical compounds such as methane, ammonia, and water that are wholly frozen because they are extremely far from the Sun, and therefore solar radiation does not melt them nor evaporate them. It is currently known that the objects in the Kuiper Belt are so far away from the Sun that it would be impossible for any of them to have water in a liquid state. So it is not a place of interest for the search for extraterrestrial life. Number 8. Neptune, the orchestra director. Although the distances between the planets in the solar system are vast, the gravity of giant planets such as Jupiter, Saturn, Uranus, and Neptune can influence each other and generate something called orbital resonance. The orbital resonance can be expressed as a simple relationship between the orbital periods of the two objects. For example, if a planet completes two orbits around a star at the same time that another nearby planet completes three orbits around the same star, there is a 2-3 orbital resonance between the two planets. Today we know that some KBOs are in orbital resonance with Neptune since their orbital periods are fractions of Neptune's orbital period. Until now, objects have been observed with two types of orbital resonance. Objects in 1-2 resonance that complete two orbits around the Sun every time Neptune completes one. These objects are called tutinos. Objects with a 2-3 resonance that completes three orbits of the Sun every time Neptune completes two are classified as plutinos. In this way, Neptune is the orchestra director who directs the symphony of the KBO as they orbit the Sun. Before moving on, be sure to like or dislike the video so that we can improve them for you, the viewer. Plus, don't forget to subscribe to our channel by making sure to hit the notification bell so you don't miss any of our daily videos. Number 7. It's huge. Look at this image. The central yellow dot is the Sun. The red dots with letters are the planets Jupiter, Saturn, Uranus, and Neptune, and the disk with the blue and orange dots are the KBOs known to date. As you can see, the number of objects in the Kuiper Belt is enormous, significantly surpassing that of the asteroid belt in quantity and size. The Kuiper Belt lies beyond Neptune, extending approximately 30 to 50 astronomical units, or AU, from the Sun. For context, an AU is the average distance between the Earth and the Sun, about 149.6 million kilometers. It means KBOs are up to 50 times farther from the Sun than Earth. The KBOs are made mainly of ice because at these distances, the amount of sunlight is minimal and the solar radiation is feasible, so no object managed to heat up as much as the inner planets do. And that is why the ice, instead of sublimating or evaporating, remains in that state indefinitely. Number 6. Uncertain origin. Just as the asteroid belt between Mars and Jupiter has an uncertain origin, the Kuiper Belt has a, until now, an unknown origin. However, observed evidence in astronomer simulations indicate that both originated similarly. The asteroid belt was formed by the interaction of Jupiter with a protoplanetary disk between Mars and Jupiter. In contrast, the gravitational interaction of the ice giants Uranus and Neptune formed the Kuiper Belt. The most accepted simulation so far suggests that initially the Kuiper Belt objects were remnants of the formation of the solar system that was found in the region close to the gas giants, while some planets like Saturn acquired orbital resonance with other planets, and the total sums of the forces of gravity gradually moved the KBO away until they reached their current orbit at almost 50 astronomical units. In short, KBOs were initially remnants of the formation of the solar system closer to the Sun, but eventually the gravitational forces of the gas giant planets moved them away until they reached the area where they are currently located. Number 5. Natural Time Capsule. Thanks to the fact that the KBO is permanently frozen, any phenomena in them is recorded and remains unchanged for billions of years. This means that KBOs may be time capsules that hold records of everything that happened in the solar system billions of years ago. An example of this is meteorite impact craters. On Earth, when a meteorite impacts the Earth's surface, over the years, the erosion of rain and wind erases the impact crater, adding to the surface changes due to geological activity such as volcanic eruptions or earthquakes. Eventually, after millions of years, a meteorite impact crater on Earth has been almost completely erased, and there's no way we can find out where or when meteorites fell on Earth, except for those that fell in areas with minor erosion and little geological activity, like deserts. Asteroids and KBOs have no geological activity or erosion, so everything that happens on their surfaces can be recorded on them for billions of years without any change. This allows us to study what these types of events were like in the past of the solar system, and thus know how the planets evolved throughout history and how asteroid impacts changed as the solar system changed. Number 4. Home of possible planets. As mentioned earlier, the Kuiper Belt has a mass that exceeds that of the asteroid belt by more than 200 times. Furthermore, we have not yet discovered all the existing KBOs, so many astronomers think it would be possible to find larger objects in the Kuiper Belt. Until a few decades ago, astronomers were utterly unaware of the existence of other dwarf planets besides Pluto. However, since the 2000s, thanks to the advancements of science and astronomical observation technology, we have discovered increasingly smaller and more distant objects. This is how, in 2005, we found the dwarf planets Eris, Makemake, and Haumea, three large Kuiper Belt bodies. It was initially estimated that Eris was slightly larger than Pluto, and that Eris was in fact the legendary Planet X. Years after the discovery of Eris, the New Horizons Space Exploration Probe passed by Pluto, revealing that its actual size was approximately 2,370 kilometers, so we now knew that Pluto was larger than Eris. However, astronomers do not rule out that, just as our technology was able to find Eris, it is possible that in the future the new generation of astronomical observatories and space exploration missions we'll be able to find new objects. Some astronomers even suggest that it would not be far-fetched to find a planet the size of Mars in the Kuiper Belt. Number 3. Origin of comets. For years, one of the biggest mysteries of the solar system that astronomers didn't know how to answer was, where did comets come from? Many astronomers speculated that due to their composition, mainly ice, comets come from the most distant and coldest areas of the solar system. In 1943, in the Journal of the British Astronomical Association, scientist Kenneth Edgeworth postulated a hypothesis that in the region beyond Neptune, the material within the primordial solar nebula is too widely spaced to condense into planets, and therefore must be concentrated in the billions of more small and colder bodies. Later, astronomer Gerard Kuiper speculated that during the early stages of the solar system, there must have been a belt of material beyond Neptune's orbit. However, he didn't believe that such a belt still existed today. Kuiper had the assumption, common in his time, that Pluto was the size of Earth, and therefore had dispersed these bodies into the Oort cloud, or out of the solar system. However, years later, with the improvement of astronomical observatories, it was discovered that Pluto's diameter was much smaller, and therefore did not have the gravitational force to move all those objects away. Eventually, in the modern era, KBOs will be discovered. Astronomers will conclude that this region of the solar system beyond the orbits of the planets is occupied by a large number of tiny icy bodies, and that from time to time, one of them leaves its orbit, rushing towards the Sun, appearing as an occasional visitor to the inner solar system, that is, what we know as a comet. In short, short-period comets like the famous Halley's Comet were initially a KBO that fell out of its orbit and hurled towards the Sun, becoming a comet. Number 2. Origin of Moons. Just as a KBO can leave its orbit and become a comet, sometimes these can be captured by the gravity of a planet. Then instead of becoming comets, they become natural satellites of another planet. Such is the case of Triton, a moon of Neptune, and Phoebe, a moon of Saturn. Both moons have bizarre orbits around their respective planets, which had led astronomers to speculate that these natural satellites were not formed together with their planets, and in reality they were captured by the gravity of Neptune and Saturn and subsequently became their natural satellites. So the Kuiper Belt is not only home to short-period comets, but also is the place where some moons originated. Number 1. Kuiper Cliff. The Kuiper Cliff is the name scientists give to the farthest part of the Kuiper Belt. It is a mystery that has existed for years, and that in this region, the density of objects in the Kuiper Belt decreases drastically, hence the name Cliff. For this anomaly, several hypotheses are used. The most accepted explains that, in reality, there is a population of objects in the farthest part of the Kuiper Belt, only that they have not yet been grouped into more massive objects of sufficient size, so that they can be observed and detected by modern technology. The second hypothesis explains that the objects in this area were swept by a planetary body that would have to be the size of Earth or Mars, suggesting that it would be a hypothetical trans-Neptunian planet. Could it be that this planet is the mythical Planet 9 that astronomers have been searching for years? What do you think about all these exciting facts about the Kuiper Belt? Let us know your opinion in the comments.